Yeah. we honor and recognize Him. I want you to understand, sometimes we Pentecostals are guilty of being too casual with God's presence. We're too casual with the move of God. We take it for granted and we say, well, that's run of the mill. It's not run of the mill. It's an honor for God to come down to this place and to be in our midst. Multiply thousands of churches around this world would love to have what you have now, as God is in this place. And I want you to understand, He's not here for no use and no reason. He's here for a purpose. God is in our midst to intervene for you. God is in our midst to intervene for you and your need, your problem, your situation. Whatever it is, doesn't matter how big or how small it may seem to anybody, it's important to God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I want you to understand this. It's important to God. It's important for Him to come from the throne room of glory and usher His presence in this house. Here in Gadsden, Alabama, zip code 35904. God is here. With us. And this is what He says. He said, if you will believe and receive My Spirit, there is not one need that will not be met. If you will believe and receive, is what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. I don't care what it, I don't care if it's cancer, I don't care if it's tuberculosis, it doesn't matter what it is, if it's a simple skin rash, if it's shingles, whatever it is, God will meet every need. Doesn't matter if it's diabetes, high blood pressure, doesn't matter if it's arthritis, bursitis, every need will be granted if you believe and receive in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Right where you are, receive. Believe and receive. In Jesus' name. Sister Martha, the answer is on you. The answer is on you. In Jesus' name. My God, my God, my God. All of this congregation, the Spirit of the Lord is moving. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. you and help encourage you. Those of you that have a specific need, I want you to line up here. And I'm not going to pray for you. Your brothers and sisters are with great faith. All across this front, all these people that are lining up, all across, it's going to cover the whole front and more. Just remain standing. All across the front. In Jesus' name. God's not going to touch you. Your need will be met. It is not optional. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. If we can move toward the left a little bit, there's more coming on that side. God will help us. God bless you. There may be more. There may be twice as many. Come and stand in front of each one of these. It's all right for several.
doors if you would still be sitting here. I want you to get up and say, God, I need you more than I need that next for you. Hallelujah. Oh, God is waiting on you. Hallelujah. He's done everything that he's going to do. Hallelujah. Yes.
Thank you. person beside you.
Sing this song again, everybody. If you can stand, if you're not able, I understand. But if you can stand, please stand.
Thank you.
Father loves us so much. He's gone up in heaven with a scepter in his hand, and he choked the head for failing. But I see him as a heavenly Father and Jesus, a Son, with his arms reached wide open, saying, come to me. Come unto me. And he's letting us know he wants to just simply love us like the hill. If we've strayed away from him, come back to him. Love him. Love him. And accept his forgiveness. Love him in Jesus' name. How bless you. Is there anyone who needs to pray? In Jesus' name. Thank you, ministers. Thank you so much. God bless you. Such an important part of this great church. Praise God for everyone.
What you're doing, all of this congregation. thank you for saving and forgiving. And now, Lord, I pray that you help them forgive themselves. Help them forgive themselves of any and all sin, no matter what it is, doesn't matter. And the Spirit of God dwells in you. 1 Corinthians 3:16. Know ye not that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you?
Amen.
Hallelujah. When you know you're the temple of God, when you know you are the temple of God, and the Spirit of God dwells in you. When you know you're the temple, you are the temple of God. This building's not the temple of God. It's a structure, it's a building that houses the temple of God. And as a temple of God, the Spirit of God dwells inside of you. You said, but preacher, you mean inside of me? Inside of him? Yes. Inside of Charlotte? Inside of Mary? Inside of Helenbayo? Inside of Nathan? Inside of Ernest? Inside of Brother Bill? Brother Dallas? Sister Shirley, you're saved, don't you?
Yes, sir.
I didn't have to ask you that. I knew the answer before asking. The Spirit of God, the Spirit of Christ dwells in you. I don't want you to understand, when God intervenes, He is ever looking for ways to bless you and intervene for you. He's not way off somewhere in a far off planet. Even though planet in heaven, I don't know how far it is. Nobody's ever measured and knows. But I know one thing. That time I went, it didn't take me long to get there. In the Spirit.
That's right.
You talk about spirit speed and spirit travel. Before I could get back to the back wall, I could be in heaven. That's how long it takes to get there, and quicker. And how wonderful it is whenever God intervenes. He does a good job of intervening. But we ask Him, and I heard Him say something. How that if we would just believe Him and receive, there is not one need that will be unmet that you have to leave the church house today. He didn't say that you had to mean it. He didn't say the preacher had to mean it. He didn't say these musicians had to mean it or anyone else. He will mean it. And he'll keep his word, whatever. You see, God can't lie. And when he says anything, it is. It is. There used to be a lot of counts going around that the men wore and maybe some women that says, if God said it, I believe it, it's so, but I'm going to correct that. If God said it, that settles it. Doesn't matter if you believe it or not. Because when he says it, it is. Hallelujah. When God intervenes, when you know you're in the temple of God, well, this would be a good time to preach on true worship. I love those series of messages, true worship. I hope you never tire of them. I may want to preach them again here not too long in the future. When you realize that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you, just like he dwelt in the holy place and the most holy place in the temple, you took the place of that temple. You are the housing, the shell for the Holy of Holies. And the Spirit of God comes in to your spirit and occupies your temple. You are the temple of Almighty God. You are the temple. You're not God, but you're the temple of God. You house a place for God's Spirit to dwell in. Hallelujah. Why don't you swing wide the door and make him welcome? Hallelujah. When you're a child of God, he's there, but sometimes we humans don't realize and comprehend and recognize he's there. When you begin realizing who you are, who he is, and who's inside of you, it changes your attitude. That stinking thinking that you had gets to be a sweet smelling savior. Hallelujah. You get to smelling that instead of stinking like a skunk. Amen. Heaven, Jesus. Let me share a story right fast. I'm closing. And you say, well, the day of miracles is not over. If I quit before 12, there was a train that housed the Queen of England, Queen Victoria, rather. There was a British express train that was racing through the night. Its a powerful headlight, spearing the black darkness, parting it. And as I said, the train was carrying Queen Victoria. Suddenly, the engineer saw a startling sight. Revealed in the beam of the engine's headlights was a weird figure in a black cloak standing in the middle of the tracks and waving its arms. The engineer grabbed the brakes and pulled back as hard as he could, brought the train to a grinding halt. He and his fellow trainsmen climbed out of the engine to see what had stopped and had happened. And they found no trace of the strange figure. On a hunch, the engineer walked a few yards further up the tracks, and suddenly he stopped and stared into the fog in horror that the bridge had been washed out. Yeah. Where the train would have gone. Right. But God intervened. The train would have run off into a ravine in the swollen stream and killed probably everybody on board. Right. If he had not heeded the ghostly figure, the train would have plunged into the stream. Amen. While the bridge and tracks were being repaired, the crew made a more intensive search for the strange flagman, but not until they got to London did they solve the mystery. At the base of the engine's headlamp, the engineer discovered a huge dead moth. Amen. Think about it. The moth had flown into the beam seconds before the train was to reach the washed out bridge. When Queen Victoria was told of this strange happening, She said, I'm sure it was no accident. It was God's way of protecting us. God used a moth to protect that whole train from disaster. Sometimes God uses little things to protect you and me from disaster. Praise God for using a moth to protect the Queen of Great Britain and Europe and England and all the other passengers. And God has used so many little things that He created to protect you and me. Star and I were on a little mini trip on our anniversary, June the 25th. We went to Little River Canyon and was looking around and enjoying the scenery and enjoying being with each other. And as we went through that way, we were gonna go on up to Chattanooga and have a little more leisure time there. And instead, I asked her, I said, do you want to go to Chattanooga? She said, nah, let's just go back home. So we came back and went to prayer meeting. It would have been a prayer meeting. And got back here. And we heard on the news at the same time we would be in Chattanooga, at the same place on the interstate, there was a 9-car pileup, and I don't remember how many people were killed. And we would have been right there in the middle of it had we not come back home. God protects His children. God is so good. It wouldn't have been wrong for us to go to Chattanooga and enjoy ourselves, but it would have been deadly if we had gone. You say, well, preacher, God could protect you. He could, but He puts little thoughts in our heads to protect us. And if we listen, He protects us. If we don't listen to that still small voice, He's not obligated to protect us. But how good God is when God intervenes. Hallelujah. I don't know what I'll preach tonight, if I continue that or another thought. But I want to tell you, God has intervened this morning. Some of you, I don't know what all the needs are, but some of you are in some dangerous territory. And God rescued you from dangerous territory. Love you. Praise God. And I praise God for what the Lord has done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.